हेलो माय डियर क्लास 9th आईसीएसई बोर्ड स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर कीपिंग वेल। सो वंस अगेन आई एम विथ यू। द वीडियो इज फॉर द टॉपिक कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट। आई एक्सप्लेन यू इन द लास्ट वीडियो हाउ टू calculate the compound interest on a certain sum for a certain time period. But in that video I explained the calculation without help of the formula. Means we calculated the interest year by year. I did first 5 questions of exercise 2A. So on demand of the students, I am going to do the remaining questions of exercise 2A. In that, we will do the questions without using the formula. Okay. So let us do the question number 6 of exercise 2A. The question says, find the amount and compound interest, both amount and compound interest, on a sum of rupees 15,625 at 4% per annum compounded annually for 3 years. My dear students, in the examination, if the method's name is not mentioned, you can get the answer by any suitable method. I mean, either without using formula or using formula. It is up to you. But I am going to do this question without using formula. So let us start doing year by year calculation. We will make first year. For first year, principal 15,625 rupees. Interest of first year 15,625 into rate into time upon 100. 25, 6 ja 150, 6 is remainder 62, 25, 2 ja 50, 12 remainder 125, 625 rupees. So the amount at the end of 1 year will be principal plus interest 15,625 plus 625 5 5 10 2 2 4 1 5 6 6 12 5 1 6 ₹16,250. So this principal, this amount will be considered as the principal for the second day. For second year, principal 16,250. Interest, as I have told you, my dear students, second year is also the time period of 1 year only, as this is. Whether it is first year, second year, or third year, it is a time period of 1 year only. Don't get confused that second year means the timing will be 2 years. No, time duration will be 1 year only. So interest, P into R into T upon 100. 25 6 ja 150 25 5 ja, so we get ₹650 as the compound interest of second year. So amount at the end of second year, my dear students, compound interest of 1 year is 625, which is simple interest of 1 year also. Compound interest of second year is 650. But if you are asked compound interest in 2 years, instead of compound interest of second year, you are asked compound interest in 2 years. So it means the sum of interest of first year and the interest of second year. There is difference between compound interest in 2 years and compound interest of second year. This is second year, second year's compound interest. While compound interest in 2 years will be equal to the sum of this one plus this one. But the amount in 2 years, our amount at the end of second year, both means same, and that I am going to get. Amount in 2 years is same as the amount at the end of second year. So we will add this principal and this interest. 16,250 plus 650. 16,900 rupees. Now is the time to get the principal for the third year. Principal, ₹16,900. Interest, ₹16,900 into 4 into 1 upon 100. ₹16,900 into 4 into 1 upon 100. ₹25 6 ja 150 19 190 25 7 ja 175 15 is remainder 50 25 6 ja interest is 676 rupees. What are we asked? We are asked to find the amount and the compound interest for 3 years. So this is the interest of third year and this is the principal of third year. So amount at the end of third year or amount in 3 years is equal to principal plus interest. $17,576. This is the first part. In second part, we are asked compound interest in 3 years. So we have two options. Either we should add first year, second year, and third year interest together, or we have to subtract the principal from original principal from the final amount. So I am using the shortcut. Final amount minus original principal equals to compound interest in 3 years. Six minus 5, 1. 7 minus 2, 5. 15 minus 6, 9. 6 minus 5, 1. So rupees 1951 is second part's answer. Question number 7. In question number 7, we have to find the compound interest after 3 years which the Anurag will pay. Anurag took a loan of 8,000 from a bank. If the rate of interest is at 5% per annum compounded annually, calculate the compound interest that Anurag will have to pay after 3 years. Same procedure. Instead of getting the amount in 3 years, we have to just get the compound interest to be paid by Anurag in 3 years. Let us see. For Anurag, the principal or sum borrowed is rupees 8,000. The rate of interest charged by the bank is 5%. Compounded yearly. The time is 3 years. First year, principal 8,000, interest 8,000 into 5 into 1 upon 100. ₹400 amount. 8,000 plus 400. 8,000, 400. Second year, principal 8,400. interest 8400 into 5 into 1 upon 100. Amount 8400 plus 420 for third year. Principal 8820. Interest 8820 into 5 into 1 upon 100. ₹441. What we need? We need the compound interest paid by the Anurag in 3 years. So compound interest in 3 years equals to 400 plus 420 plus 441, 1261 rupees. 1261 rupees. One more interesting, some of you might be thinking, why sir is doing the question by a lengthy procedure. The procedure is lengthy, but it is understandable. There is a shortcut, and that shortcut says that to use the formula. I can use the formula, my dear students, and I will use in second exercise. I will explain it. But here in this question, I would like to explain you something else which is not mentioned in your book. So just listen to me carefully and watch the video. What is that? If I ask, what is the principal for the first year? I hope you all will say, sir, very easy question you are asking. Principal for first year you have written 8000. Then my question is, what is the principal for the second year? You will say, sir, you have written here. You have written here. Sorry, not this one, this one. Very good. You have given me the correct answer. The principal for first year is 8000, principal for second year is 8400. Now, I ask you to do one work. What is that? Find the interest on 8000 rupees. I am giving you a work. And if you are unable, I will do. Find the interest on this principal for 1 year. Find the interest on this principal for 1 year at 5% per annum rate of interest. What I said, to calculate the interest on this at the rate of 5% in 1 year. You will say, sir, very simple. 8000 into 5 into 1 upon 100. You will say, sir, 400. Then you will say, sir, why are you doing this? I have done it here. Okay, yes, you have done. 400. So, when you add the 400, which is interest on this, you get the principal for the second year. So, what can we say? We can say that the principal for the second year is equal to the amount at the end of 1 year. And same thing we can say that principal for third year is equal to the principal for third. When you add the principal with the interest, you get the amount, and that is equal to the principal. Now, second thing I am saying, to get the amount at the end of 1 year. What is the amount at the end of 1 year? 8,400. Here we wrote na amount at the end, 8,400. This is the amount at the end of 1 year, and this is the amount at the end of 2 years. Okay. Amount at the end of 1 year is 8,400. Amount at the end of 2 years is 8,820. And amount at the end of third year, I have not calculated that one also. Let us calculate amount at the end of third year, 441 plus 8,820. Nine two six one is the amount in 3 years. 8,820 is the amount in two years, and 8,400 is the amount in 1 year. This is the amount in 1 year. This is the amount in 2 years. This is the amount in 3 years. So what interesting fact I am going to tell you? Listen to me. This amount in 1 year will be or can be considered as the principal for the calculation of amount of second year. Amount in 2 years. I think little bit confusing thing I am saying. Let me make it clear again. Amount in 1 year is equal to amount in 1 year is this one. Amount in 2 years is this one. So amount in 2 years is equal to this one plus the interest. This one plus the interest means for the second year, for the end of 2 years, amount is equal to the amount at the end of 1 year plus the interest on it. What does it mean? I am saying that amount in 2 years is equal to amount in 1 year plus interest on amount in 1 year. Similarly, I am saying that amount in 3 years, I'm not cutting it third year. Amount in 3 years is equal to amount in 2 years plus interest. Amount in 2 years plus interest. So if it is not clear, I write this into a formula form. Please see what am I saying. I am saying that A2 means amount in 2 years. A1 plus interest on A1 in 1 year. Similarly for third year and second year. What am I saying? A3, amount in 3 years equals to amount in 2 years plus interest on amount in 2 years in 1 year. This formula you will not see in your book. Next one. Compound interest in 2 years is equal to compound interest in 1 year plus interest on compound interest in 1 year, compound interest in of third year, compound interest of third year is equal to compound interest of second year, CI2 means compound interest of second year, plus interest on CI2 in 1 year. You can note it down and you can use it in the questions, but not in this exercise. In next exercise, I will be using this formula. You can note it down. Question number 8 now. The basics of this formula is that if you know the amount at the end of second year, okay, and you want to get the amount at the end of third year, so just amount at the end of second year and the amount at the end of second year, and that you calculate the interest, and when you add the interest to the amount of 2 years, you will get the amount of third year. Same thing for calculation of compound interest. If you know the compound interest of second year and you want to get the compound interest of third year, what will you be doing? Calculate the interest on compound interest of second year for 1 year, and that interest, when you add to compound interest of second year, you will be able to get the compound interest of third year. I am saying that third year interest is equal to the interest on second year compound interest plus compound interest of second year. If it is not clear, don't worry. I will be explaining you in the questions. Question number 8. We have Maria invest 93,750 Maria invests 93,750 at 9.6% per annum. For 3 years, and the interest is compounded annually. Calculate first part. What we have to calculate? The amount standing to her credit at the end of second year, means amount in 2 years. Okay, let us do for first year. Principal is equal to 93,750. Interest 93,750 into 9.6 into 1 upon 100. So 93,750 into 9,000. So amount at the end of first year will be 93,750 plus 9,000 1,02,750 for second year. Principal is equal to 1,02,750 इंटरेस्ट 1,02,750 इंटू 9.6 इंटू 1/100 10275 into 9.6 equals to 9864 9864. So when we add the interest of second year to the principal for second year, we will get the amount at the end of second year, or amount in 2 years. So amount in 2 years is equal to 10,2750 plus 9864. So amount at the end of second year means amount in 2 years is equal to 1,12,614. Second part, the interest for third year. So this principal, now is the time to do the second part differently. But before doing it differently, I will do it in the simple way which you are understanding. What is that? We want to get the compound interest for the third year. Compound interest for third year. So to get the compound interest of third year, we should have the principal for third year. And principal for third year is same as the amount at the end of second year. So principal is equal to 1,12,614. So interest 1,12,614 into rate 9.6 into time upon 100. So 1,12,614 into 10,810.944. 10,810.944. This is the compound interest in third year. But what I said, we can get the compound interest of third year by a different way which I explained to you few moments before. What was that? I said that compound interest of third year equals to compound interest of second year plus the interest on second year compound interest in 1 year. Compound interest of second year, have we calculated? Yes, 9864. This is the compound interest of second year. So to calculate the compound interest of second year, what I said? Sorry, third year. Compound interest of second year plus interest on this. I repeat, this is interest of second year. We want the interest of third year, which will definitely be more than this. So on this, when you calculate the interest and when you add the calculated interest with this, you will get this answer. Let us check it. I am saying that when we calculate The interest on this, interest on second year compound interest. So 9864 into 9.6 into 1/100. 9864 is the interest of second year. So when you calculate interest on second year interest and add the calculated interest with the second year interest, you will get the third year interest like this. Just equal to this. Let us do. So 9864 into 0.096, we get 946.944. 946.944. This is the interest on second year compound interest in 1 year. When you add this interest with second year compound interest, you will get third year compound. Let us see. So compound interest in compound interest of third year equals to 9864 plus 946.944. 4, 4, 9, 4, 6, 10. 6, 4, 10, 11. 9, 8, 17, 18. Yes. So the things what I explained, I have made it clear to you. What I explained? I explained that compound interest of third year is equal to the compound interest of second year plus the interest on second year for 1 year. Similarly, in case of amount of third year is equal to amount of second year plus the interest on amount of second year of 1 year. Next one, question number 9. A sum of 9600 is invested for 3 years at 10% per annum. Rate 10%. Time 3 years. What we want to calculate in the first part? What is the sum due at the end of first year? Amount in 1 year. Let us get principal equals to 9600. Interest 9600 into 10 into 1/100. Don't write here 3. 960 rupees. So amount 9600 plus 960, 10,560 rupees is the answer of the first part. Second one, what is the sum due at the end of second year? Sum due at the end of second year. So for second year, so I said and I am going to do. This is the amount at the end of 1 year. And what we want the next? Amount at the end of second year. So when we add the interest on this amount, to this interest, we will get the amount of second year. This is the amount of first year. Calculate the interest on this of 1 year and add the result to this. You will get the you do it, I know. For second year, you can write here principal 10,560 Interest. Calculate the interest. 10,560 into 10 into 1 upon 100. 1056. So when you add this interest to the amount at the end of second year, you will get the amount at the end of third year. When you add this interest of second year to the amount at the end of 1 year, you will get the amount in 2 years. So amount in 2 years or second year equals to 10,560 plus 1056. 11,616. Third part, find the compound interest earned in the first 2 years. Compound interest in 2 years. So compound interest in 2 years means the sum of the interest of first year and second year. 960 plus 1056. 6, 6, 5, 11, 9, 1, 10, 2, 0, 1, 6 rupees. Third part. Okay. Fourth part. Find the compound interest at the end of 3 years. So compound interest at the end of 3 years. So this amount in 2 years will be considered as the principal for third year. Principal 11,616. Interest 11,616 into 10 into 1 upon 100. 1,161.60 rupees is the interest of third year. But what are we asked? We are asked to find the compound interest at the end of 3 years. Find the compound interest at the end of 3 years. For that we will add. Therefore compound interest in 3 years equals to 960 plus, sorry, where is the 960 plus 1056 plus 1,161.60 3,177.60 rupees. So this will be the compound interest in 3 years. I hope the things which what I explained are clear to you. If not, continue watching my video. I will make everything clear to you by the end of this chapter. In case of doubt, you can raise the question. So wait for the new video to come. Bye bye.